it's only appropriate that we do the opposite and one player that every club should sell. Now, if you watch the other video, in that video I tried to go for ones which aren't really obvious ones, sort of out there ones, and that's what we're gonna do with this one today as well. I'm not just gonna tell you, or most of the time I'm not gonna just tell you a real obvious one who's like dead wood and just needs to go. I'm gonna try and do some which are a little bit out there, so if you season where he barely played, got only 9 games played, and he's at has suffered heavily with injuries throughout his time at Brighton, but this season, when he has been fit, De Zerbi just hasn't picked him because he thinks he doesn't really suit his style. Barely been used. Now he's still only 22, so I think he could come good, but this is definitely a sellable player for Brighton, and a move away is probably best, as it seems he won't really be part of De Zerbi's plans, at least right now. Maybe in the future it could become, but I don't think De Zerbi really rates him, and Bright could get still a very good fee for him. Burnley, Jack Cork. Now, there was barely anyone to pick for Burnley, as half their squad has already gone because they were on loan. So I've just gone Jack Cork. Now he played quite a bit last season, 26 times, helping Burnley go up, but I think his game time this year will be much, much lower in the Prem, and he's only got a year left on his deal. This may be the time to get rid of him. You might be able to get a little bit of a fee for him, and then replace him for a more long-term, younger player, but yeah, wasn't really anyone to pick from at Burnley, so if Jack Cork stays around, I'm not opposed to that as well. Chelsea, now, I literally, on the other hand, but Chelsea could have gone for the whole squad, but maybe one which isn't really talked about right now. I'm going for Ian Maatsen. Now, I think Maatsen is a really good left back, and ideally, I, as a Chelsea fan, want him to stay, but realistically, now is probably the time for him to leave. He was instrumental last season in helping Burnley go up when he was there on loan, but he's now returned, he's back at Chelsea, but with Ben Chilwell clearly ahead of him, and Mark Cucurella, who we've spent all that money on, doesn't look like he'll be going anywhere, is going to be ahead of him as well. Maatsen is going to be third choice left back, so he isn't going to get much game time. Now he's only got a year left on his deal, so that's why I think Chelsea probably need to sell him, because unless he signs a new deal, which, if I'm being 100% honest, if I'm Ian Maatsen, I'm not doing that because I'm just going to get sent out on loan again. But if he doesn't sign a new deal, then Chelsea need to get rid of him, because you can get some decent money for somebody who is not going to be playing next season. Crystal Palace, Jean-Philippe Mendeta. Now, unfortunately, he's just not really worked out at Crystal Palace. Mendeta, I would say he's shown some flashes here and there, but he's just not really good enough to be a starting striker for a Premier League side, in my opinion. Can't really rely on him in front of goal. He only got 2 goals last season, and especially when you consider he's got players like Eze, Elise, Cesar, while creating for him, he really should have been doing better than that. And also, you know, under Hodgson, right, the goals were flying in, but Mendeta again, I think he only got 1 goal under him, so yeah, I think if you're Palace, you got your losses and you try and get a proper number 9 to come in next season. Everton, now speaking of number 9s, this is a bit of a crazy shout, but just hear me out on this one. So we're going Dominic Calvert-Lewin. Now, I don't think Everton should be actively trying to sell Calvert-Lewin, because when fit, he's clearly their best and only attacker who can actually score goals. But that's the problem, when fit. Unfortunately, he's never fit. And I think if somebody came in for him with a decent offer, you'd probably take if you're Everton, because you just don't know if Calvert-Lewin will ever be fit. He might just be one of those players who just always get injured, because that's what it seems like right now. So if you do get a good bid, which I think could happen, I think there could potentially be some clubs who consider taking a punt on him. I think if you're Everton, you take it. You use that money to go buy another more reliable striker you can count on to be fit. Watch the other video if you want to know who I suggest they should buy in that position. And you know, Everton struggling financially, that could help them out a bit. But yeah, I mean, I wouldn't actively look to get rid of him, but maybe, you know, if enough So he's attracted quite a bit of interest from clubs in Italy and also Spurs, apparently. And considering he only has a year left on his deal, this is really the perfect time for Fulham to sell on him. I think he probably will be sold. Now, he played quite a bit for Fulham last year, so he would be a miss. But the thing is, there were also spells in the season where he was benched for Issa Diop, so it's not like they would be losing like a huge, huge player here for them. So I think this is one that makes sense, selling for a decent fee. Player a year left and still got a lot of interest, not a vital, vital player to the team, and you can get a decent fee for him and buy a probably good replacement for him. Liverpool, Joe Gomez. Now, somebody we mentioned in the summer plan video we did on Liverpool. Unfortunately, it looks like Joe Gomez isn't going to become the player we once thought. He's had an absolutely shocking season. He made three errors. He was always losing possession on the ball, constantly getting spun. Didn't really seem comfortable playing in a high line. And Gomez, I don't know what's happened, but he just does not look like the player he was before. He's one of the only players who Liverpool can really get a decent amount before. So I think he should probably move on. Liverpool try and get rid of him. And I also think for his career as well, he's at an age now where he needs to be playing regular football. So he needs a fresh start to really revive his career, in my opinion. Next up, Luton. And I've got Elijah Adebayo. Now, this one was quite hard. So Luton, as we know, have quite a small budget. They aren't going to spend loads, so they're going to need to raise a bit of money. And one of the players who can actually get some decent money in if he's sold is Elijah Adebayo. Now, despite being a solid player for Luton up top in the Championship, I don't know if he's a Premier League level striker. He does give me those sort of Kiefer Moore vibes. Could probably score a few, but you know, he's really going to be a handful, but isn't really going to get you more than maybe 6 Premier League goals. But that's probably going to bite me in the back, isn't it? So yeah, I think you could probably sell him and get some decent money as well, because I think a lot of Championship clubs would take him, as he's a proven good Championship striker. So yeah, I would get rid of Adebayo. Man City, Bernardo Silva. Now, Bernardo, there's an obvious one, Cancelo, but like I said, we're not going for obvious it. So the reason I picked Bernardo Silva is because for the last like 2 seasons he's been linked with a move away, so I think now is probably the time to move on for that reason. But I mean, credit to him because he has been committed and given his all despite being linked away. However, I think his time at City has probably come to an end. He clearly wants a new challenge. He's been an incredible player, but if he is not 100% committed, then he needs to move on. And you can get some real good money as well for him because he is a top player, but it seems like he wants a new challenge. So yeah, I think just sort of end it now, go out on a high, just want the treble, and you can cash in on him. Man United, again, I could have gone for loads of players here. Watch the summer video, summer plan video I did on them if you want to hear about all the names, but I'm going for one which maybe isn't as obvious. We're going Jadon Sancho. Now, it just hasn't worked out for him at United. It's really sad to see, to be honest, because he came in with such promise, but now looks nowhere near the levels for Man United. Like, at best, he's probably a squad player, but to be honest, I think if United are serious about challenging next season, you can't be playing Jadon Sancho for many games. And I also think for his sake and his career, he needs a fresh start, get out of the spotlight, get out of Man United to go get back on track. So I think if you're United, for me, you sell him, cut your losses now while you can still get a decent fee and then move on, because clearly he's not good enough. You know, they've tried a lot of things. He even went to a training camp, individual training on his own, and you know, he came back a little bit better, but Seem like he wants to be there, to be honest. started off well, to be fair, but I think maybe a falling out or something happened behind the scenes. I do think he's a good player. He's just been used completely wrong at West Ham. If David Moyes left, I probably would say he could stay under a new manager, but it looks like Moyes will stay. Still has some value. West Ham should just really move on from this awful signing. And finally, Wolves, Raul Jimenez, a real sad one, but Jimenez, since the head injury, has just never been the same. Before the injury, he hit 13 goals and then 17 in the league, and he had 4 in 10 games for Wolves, but after the head injury, in 50 Premier League games, he scored just 6 goals, and last season didn't even get one. It's a real sad one, but it's clear he's just not the same player anymore, and Wolves need to move him on, as they have a lot of strikers on the books who just aren't good enough, and Jimenez, unfortunately, is one who isn't good enough, and with his age, doesn't really have a future at Wolves, I don't think. So, yeah, probably best to let him